Hey guys, greetings from Knoxville, Tennessee on the 21st of January, 2023, Saturday evening. I wanted to give a video with all of my colubrids in it. That's all I keep. I don't keep pythons or boas. And we'll start with Thunder here, who is a Stillwater bull. He is a 2021. So he's coming up on 2 years, and he's going to be a future breeder with another bull snake I'll show you here momentarily. But I love Thunder's black on his tail and his yellow head. He's got some fantastic coloring and marking and just such a sweetheart. Very well-mannered. And I just love this little guy. And I'm going to apologize in advance as I go from tub to tub. I'll be off frame, especially over there. But I want to get this in one continual shot. And he's about 3 feet long. So he's coming along well. There you go, Thunder. He does not want to let go of me. And next is my pride and joy. This is Ghost. He is a 2020 Northern Pine Snake from Ocean County, New Jersey. And he is my longest snake at over 5 feet. I know he is over 5 feet because I measured him against my 5'1" wife the other day, and he is longer than she is tall. So I'd estimate him at about 5'3". Little scale sticking up. That may be left over for some shit from some shed. But he is going to breed with my baby I got this year. I'll show you here shortly as well. The Ghost here is a little squirmy, but not defensive by any means, not aggressive. And I love having him out. He is very active. And even though I appreciate ball pythons, I'm not a big fan. They just kind of sit there. I love these active colubrids. Man, he's something. All right, Ghost, we'll put you back. And we'll grab Georgia next. She is my 2018 black milk snake. And she's the mother to all of the babies I had back in November. She's about as docile as they come. Most black milks are. And even though she's older than Ghost, she is nowhere near his size, but she's 4 feet easily. And it's interesting the difference in scales between the Lampropeltis and the Pituophis. She is so very smooth. Smooth and shiny. You're a good girl. She's awesome. We'll put her back. Don't get out. Sorry, she doesn't want to go back in. This is Atlas. Look at my cheat sheet over here. Atlas is a 2020 black milk snake. So he will be the breeder hopefully this year with Georgia. Last year I borrowed an adult male from a buddy of mine, actually who I've never met in person, but from Arkansas, and he did a great job. So Atlas has a lot to live up to. he's probably even more tame than Georgia is. He's holding on to a little bit of his red up toward his chin, but he'll be solid black probably sometime next year. And I will pair them after her next shed. She shed about a week ago. So we'll let those hormones kick in, those pre-ovulation hormones, and we'll throw them together. All right, Atlas. Again, I'm going to be off camera for a second here. I'll get Banshee, who always likes to hide under her paper. Here we go. This is a baby female pine that was produced by Jay Jacoby from his High White line. And she's not as tolerable of handling as Ghost is, but by no means is she aggressive. And she will continue to just get brighter and brighter with each shed. And if she has a growth rate like Ghost did, she'll be ready to breed by year two. She's beautiful. I have more experience with the black milk snakes, but I've got to admit, the northern pines are my favorites. I am so excited to have the opportunity to breed these guys. And Seiko sees something outside. So we'll put Banshee back. And up next will be my 2022 female bull snake. And it's funny, all of these last snakes, they're all 2022s. Some were just born much earlier in the year. You can see Cheyenne here is bigger than Banshee over there is. She was obviously an earlier hatchling. And she is a half sibling to Thunder, her future mate. And I don't know all the ins and outs of bull snake genetics, but she's developing some really nice grays. And Russ Bates, who I got both of these from, said she may have some Hannum in her lineage. Now, I don't know how those genetics cross or mix or produce, but he had her labeled as a Stillwater. So I'm going to breed a couple of Stillwaters here in the next 2 years, and we'll see what I get. So we'll put Cheyenne back. And she's such an aggressive eater. When it's feeding time and she smells the mice and I open the drawer, she'll come out like a shark with her mouth open. It's pretty cool to see. But other than her feeding response, she's tame as a kitten. Baby girl. And this is Venus. She is my female keeper from this past, litter, this past clutch. She ate today, so I'm not going to handle her at all. She's been a picky eater, so I'm just happy that she's eating for me. She is doing very, very well now. And she will grow up to breed with Atlas as well. And she'll be as unrelated as possible. All these black milks are somewhat related, but at least she's not a full-blown sibling. And then my final. Come here, buddy. This is the last male I have from this past clutch, which incidentally was my first clutch ever. This is M7, And he's got some really bold black. I have a feeling he's gonna turn black really quickly. He has eaten for me once, and only once, since hatching in November. But he had a really nice poop yesterday or today. So I expect him and hope that he'll eat again for me soon. But even at that, he is healthy, active, you can see. Very inquisitive, hasn't lost much body mass. He just hasn't grown yet. So once he starts eating, just like Venus, he'll hit a growth spurt and put some weight on. He's a good boy. It'll be tough to sell him off, but I really don't need two males. And I've got Venus, so I've got at least one from the clutch. Well, that's it for me, guys. Thank you for tuning in and watching. As things develop, I will certainly keep videos going. But until next time, again, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.